I just wrote some sentences. Let's read them out loud. My 13-year-old cousin's in love with space. He said, my favourite planets are Mercury, the smallest planet, Jupiter, the biggest planet, and Earth, where we live. I've remembered to use capital letters, a full stop, commas, and an exclamation mark. It looks like it's good to go.
6. Errors found.
What? How is it full of errors?
Missing. Punctuation.
Looks like there's still some punctuation missing.
Yes, I just said that.
Wait a minute. Can you hear me?
No, of course I can't. I mean... whoops.
Here are 5 more types of punctuation. Apostrophes, speech marks, colons, semicolons, and hyphens. Apostrophes are used in 2 different ways. The first is in a contraction, which is a word or phrase that has been shortened by removing some of its letters. An apostrophe is used to show where the letters are missing. For example, we can shorten did not down to didn't by removing the O and replacing it with an apostrophe. Other examples of shortening words are turning cannot into can't, I have into I've, and that is into that. The second way we use an apostrophe is to show possession. If this shirt belongs to Oliver, it's not Oliver's shirt, it's Oliver's shirt with an apostrophe before the S. Other examples of possession are Egypt's pyramids, the competition's trophy, and the Earth's atmosphere. If the word that needs an apostrophe already ends in an S, like Thomas or girls, we can either use an apostrophe and another S, or just use an apostrophe on its own. Once you've chosen which one you prefer, make sure you stick to it. Did you know that we don't always use an apostrophe to show possession? In this sentence, the word it's is showing that the tail belongs to the dog, but we don't use an apostrophe because it's is a possessive pronoun, like his, hers, and theirs. Speech marks can either be single or double, and are used to show when someone is talking. For example, shall we go out on our bikes? Layla asked. Only the bits that are spoken go inside speech marks, which shows that Layla said this sentence, but she didn't say this sentence. Other punctuation, like commas, exclamation marks, and question marks, go inside speech marks too. Colons are used to start lists. They separate the introduction of a list from the list itself. For example, to bake a cake, you will need butter, sugar, eggs, and flour. The colon separates the introduction of the ingredients from the list of ingredients. Semicolons are used to link phrases or short sentences together. For example, the mountain was huge. Ben hoped it wouldn't be too difficult to climb. These 2 sentences make sense when separated like this, but we can link them together with a semicolon to make 1 longer sentence. Instead of sounding like 2 unconnected things, the semicolon helps us show that Ben worried about climbing the mountain because it was huge. Semicolons can also be used in lists instead of commas. I invited Georgia, the chef, Elijah, the pilot, and Ava, the drummer, to my party. At first glance, this list looks like it contains 6 items. Georgia, the chef, Elijah, the pilot, Ava, and the drummer. However, not all of those commas are doing the same job. While these commas are separating the items in the list, these commas are separating the name of the person from their job title. We can make the sentence much easier to understand by replacing the commas separating the list items with semicolons. Now we know that the list only contains 3 items. Georgia, who is a chef, Elijah, who is a pilot, and Ava, who is a drummer. Hyphens are used to link words together to create compound words. Usually, adjectives, or describing words, are single words, like big, red, and shiny. But we can use a hyphen to link 2 or more single words together to make a compound adjective, like half-filled, high-tech, and left-handed. We can also use hyphens to link single words into a compound noun or naming word, like mother-in-law, dry cleaning, and 1-year-old. Okay, so we've got apostrophes, speech marks, colons, semicolons, and hyphens. This city has fallen victim to a severe case of identity theft. Real or fake? Nobody knows the difference no more. Some phony apostrophes have tried hiding in sentences where they don't belong. I've got to figure out who's innocent and who's pulling a swindle. Yeah, what is it? Fine, I'll stop doing the voice. Let's play a game. I'm going to show you a sentence with some apostrophes, and I want you to work out which ones belong there and which ones don't. That's my coat. Yours is over there. If you want, you can pause the video and do it all by yourself, or keep watching and I'll do it with you. Okay, so I can see two apostrophes in this sentence. The first one is in the word that, which is a contraction of the phrase that is. That means that this apostrophe is correct. The second apostrophe is in the word yours. It's not a contraction, but is a possessive pronoun. That means the second apostrophe is wrong. Now let's look at another sentence. The clouds are looking grey. It's going to rain later. Okay, so I can see two apostrophes again. The first one is in the plural word clouds. It's not a contraction, and although something could belong to a cloud, that's not shown in this sentence. That means the first apostrophe is wrong. The second apostrophe is in the word it, which is a contraction of the phrase it is. That means that the apostrophe here is correct. Here's the next sentence. There's a problem with Jaya's computer, so her parents are getting it fixed. Okay, so I can see three apostrophes this time. The first one is in the word theirs, which is a contraction of the phrase there is. That means this apostrophe is correct. The second apostrophe is in the word Jaya's. It's showing that the computer belongs to Jaya, so this apostrophe is also correct. The last apostrophe is in the plural word parents. It's not a contraction, and although something could belong to Jaya's parents, that's not shown in this sentence. That means the last apostrophe is wrong. Let's look at one more sentence. The hotel has got its own gyms, tennis courts, and swimming pools. Okay, I can see four apostrophes in this sentence. The first one is in the word it. This time, it's not a contraction of the phrase it is, but instead is a possessive pronoun. That means this apostrophe is wrong. The second apostrophe is in the plural word gyms. It's not a contraction, and although something could belong to a gym, that's not shown in this sentence. That means the second apostrophe is wrong too. It also looks like the third and fourth apostrophes in the plural words courts and pools are the same problem, so they're both wrong too. They thought they had me fooled, but those pesky punctuation marks didn't stand a chance. And just like that, this case is closed. Okay, so let's quickly remind ourselves of the types of punctuation again. Apostrophes are used to show contractions and possession. Speech marks show when someone is talking. Colons begin lists. Semicolons link phrases or short sentences together and separate list items that already use commas. And hyphens link words together to create compound words. Let's play another game. I'm going to write out some sentences without any of these five punctuation marks, and I want you to work out what's missing and where to put it. It was nice to see you today, my father-in-law said. If you want, you can pause the video and do it all by yourself, or keep watching and I'll do it with you. Okay, the first part of the sentence is being spoken by my father-in-law, so let's put some speech marks around it. Also, father-in-law should be a compound noun instead of three separate words, so let's link them together with hyphens. Yep, that looks right. Now let's write out another sentence. On my week-long holiday, I'm going to China, Japan, and India. Okay, so it looks like this part of the sentence is an introduction to a list, and this part is the list itself. So let's separate them with a colon. Also, week long should be a compound adjective instead of two separate words. so let's link them together with a hyphen. Finally, I'm is a contraction of the phrase I am, so it needs an apostrophe. Wonderful. Let's write out one more sentence. I met Freya's dad at the weekend, he plays chess. She told him, I'd love to beat you in a game one day. Okay, so I think there's a couple of apostrophes missing. We need one in the word Freya's, because it shows that the dad belongs to Freya. We also need one in the word I'd, because it's a contraction of the phrase I would. Next, the first sentence doesn't sound right without a pause after weekend. We could separate it into two sentences by using a full stop, but instead, let's link them together with a semicolon. Finally, the last bit of the second sentence is spoken by Freya, so let's put some speech marks around it. Great, I think that looks perfect. Okay, so let's quickly remind ourselves of the types of punctuation one more time. Apostrophes are used to show contractions and possession. Speech marks show when someone is talking. Colons begin lists. Semicolons link phrases or short sentences together and separate list items that already use commas. And hyphens link words together to create compound words. If you want to keep practicing, download the worksheet in the video description. If you haven't already, make sure to watch the first punctuation video to learn all about capital letters, full stops, commas, exclamation marks, and question marks. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to learn more science, English, and maths with Will, and let me know what you want to learn next by commenting below or emailing info@learnwithwill.co.uk.